Hello, I'm Roger Tilling. I am a British broadcaster. A lot of my work has involved hosting a lot of travel and geographical programs for television, which is perfect for me. It's my dream job because I've always loved travel. My travels have taken me all over the world, but China is a very exciting country for me, and I still have so much to explore there. I've heard about this small village in China whose entire income is derived from tourism. During 2020, this village was completely unaffected by the COVID-19 pandemic. Instead, it actually saw an increase in tourist numbers and villagers' incomes. Now, as a travel journalist, no matter which corner of the world a story originates, I will be on it like a flash. Everyone knows that the global tourism industry was hit very hard in 2020. In fact, global revenues were affected by 40%, a 40% drop, and UK revenues were even worse. They were down by 50%, in fact, more than 50%. Bohou Village is set in rural China and located on Hainan Island, which is China's southernmost province. Due to Hainan's geographic location and climate, it's often likened to Florida in the United States. The village features Lee minority-style homestays, with all bed and breakfast establishments being renovated from traditional homes. All told, there are 56 ethnic groups in China, made up of 90% Han and 10% the other 55, with the Lee ethnic group being one of them. It's a bit like when you travel to the US and you have the opportunity to stay in a native Indian American style house for a couple of days to experience the history and culture of the United States. Compared to visiting mundane city metropolises, a trip like this is often much more memorable. In fact, who could imagine that 2 or 3 years ago, these establishments were run-down old homes owned by local villagers? But since 2018, these houses have been lovingly turned into beautiful, clean, and cozy Lee-style bed and breakfasts. Tourist numbers have grown significantly. In fact, after May 2020, the global pandemic worsened. But it seemed that the pandemic completely forgot about Hainan. It didn't suffer. In fact, instead, it saw a tourism boom. It's difficult even to book a house in Bohou Village right now, and villagers' incomes have grown significantly. In fact, in just a few years, the per capita income, annual income of the small village, has increased from $700 to $4,000. That's nearly a six-fold increase. Well, this story, if not told in person by the young man that we're about to meet, I would never have believed it. His name is Dr. Lee Render. He's a 35-year-old PhD and associate professor. He was a teacher in the provincial capital city, Haikou. Yet since the beginning of 2019, he's been stationed in Bohou Village, where he has personally experienced all the changes that have taken place there. Dr. Lee, it's great to have you with us. It's brilliant to see you.
Nice to meet you.
Great to see you. And can I just say congratulations, because I've heard about the arrival of your second child.
已经三个月了.
Oh, congratulations. Well, it already looks idyllic there. It looks wonderful in Bohou Village. Whereabouts in China is Bohou Village?
博后村在海南岛的三亚亚龙湾.
Oh, so it's near the sea.
是的，在南海的边上。现在主要是民宿比较多，同时旁边也有很多的著名的景点，像森林公园、玫瑰谷、奥特莱斯等等，所以吸引了大量的游客来到博后村这里住宿、观光、旅游。
It sounds like paradise. Is there a story behind the hotel where you are?
我现在在的就是博后村的 Coco Bay 民宿。 你看，就是现在这里都有很多的模特在这里拍照，在这里取景，你可以看到这里是非常具有热带风情的一个小小的民宿，博后的hostel是48家，1500多间客房，是一个比较庞大的一个乡村的旅游点，它也一方面是给游客增加一个好去度，另外一方面也增加了村民的收入。That's
fantastic. Is there a chance to learn about the local culture?
那么博后村这个地方呢，它的村民都是黎族，所以这里有比较丰富的少数民族的文化，像黎族的文化。黎族的文化呢，它有一个传统的手工编织，黎族的传统的酿酒的技艺，传统的黎锦织锦的技艺。 还有这个传统的出海捕鱼的这种技艺。啊 ，Roger， 你来过中国旅行吗
？I have, and I absolutely loved it. I went for about a month. It was about 5 years ago, and I traveled. Actually, I have to show you a couple of things. I have the Great Wall of China on my wall.
Yeah,
Great Wall.
北京 Great Wall.
And I walked 6 miles of the Great Wall of China from Jinshanling to Simtai. That was an incredible experience.
Yes.
And so you can tell I love China, and especially because I've got these as well, my terracotta
Xi'an.
Warriors from Xi'an.
Xi'an.
So that's my little bit of China at home. Yeah.
Beijing and Xi'an are the north parts of China. But have you been to Hainan Island?
No, I haven't yet. I've still got to visit that, so I have that to look forward to.
海南是中国最南方的省份，也是一个岛屿。现在海南在建设自贸港。目前呢，海南岛内已经有了10家免税店，是世界上免税购物最集中的地方之一。
I never realized that it was the second biggest free trade port after Hong Kong. That's impressive. I didn't know that. I know you have a very very special story behind this entire project. How did you help the local villagers build this holiday paradise?
我就是在博后村的驻村扶贫干部，帮助老百姓植入产业，解决这个住房啊、饮水啊，还有这个稳定的征收方面的工作。
Did you encounter any difficulties during the transformation?
举一个例子吧，就是今年年初的时候，2021年年初的时候，因为疫情防控的方面的原因，导致很多游客到了博后村之后，没有核酸检测就无法入住民宿游客的入住率就下降了，那么村民的收入就减少了，然后我们就申请政府在博后村设立核酸检测站，设立完之后呢，在博后村就可以核酸检测，那么拿着阴性证明就可以入住了，增加了博后村的入住率，增加了村民的收入。
It must make you very happy indeed. Can you describe from your personal experience the massive difference that you've seen in the area compared to maybe 2 or 3 years ago when you first arrived?
第一个方面就是民宿群的数量的增加。19年2月我刚来的时候是15家，现在是48家，民宿的数量得到了增加，那么老百姓的收入也更加得到了增长。老百姓的文明程度也越来越提升。
One thing I thought about is that your hometown is Haikou, which is up in the very north of Hainan.And it's a very long way from Bohou Village. Do you miss your family? And how often do you get to go home?
一般是周一的时候，周一早上来到 Bohou 村子里，然后周五的傍晚的时候回到海口，坐动车不到2个小时。
You can travel every week. That's amazing.
海南的交通有一个环岛的高铁可以坐着高铁进行游览。
Wow, that is very, very fast.
Yeah.
So,
more than 250 kilometers an hour.
By British standards, that is very fast, I can tell you.
Really? Nice to meet you, really. Yes.
And when we can travel again, very soon, I hope to come over, stay in Bohou Village, and we'll have a lovely meal together. Your family...All of us together.
我和我的家人随时在等着您来到海南这里。
Congratulations again about your second child. That's brilliant news. I wish you every success in the future. Take care.